Today, we are going to attempt to present what we think is one of the greatest discoveries ever made, and an extraordinary approach to reversing chronic disease. In contemporary terms, it has become known as the Buteyko method, a system of breath training which so far has been proven to reverse asthma and many other chronic diseases. It started in the former Soviet Union more than 50 years ago, when an outspoken medical scientist claimed he could treat all kinds of diseases with a breathing method. His name was Dr.Buteyko, and he and his method became legendary as tens of thousands of people all over the country learned his method, often claiming spectacular results. It came to the West in the early 1990s when Dr. Buteyko's protégé and chief practitioner, Alexander Stalmatski, began teaching it in Sydney, Australia. Since then, profoundly positive results have been reported in media all over the world. Buteyko practice has featured positively in major newspaper articles, television documentaries, and published medical journals in Australia, New Zealand, United Kingdom, the United States, and Asia. These days, there are Buteyko practitioners all over the world, most sufficiently skilled to treat simple conditions, such as mild asthma, but only a small number who are qualified and experienced to treat severe and complex conditions. Learn Buteyko has amongst the most qualified and experienced practitioners in the world, and we specialize in treating the most severe and complex conditions. But before explaining the approach, perhaps we should try to understand a little about the man who invented it and the monumental discovery upon which it is based. Dr. Konstantin Pavlovich Buteyko was an elite Russian medical scientist who was actively engaged in high-level research for the Russian military, space, and sports programs. His specialties included high-altitude environments, respiration, the cardiovascular system, physiological measurements, and the development of diagnostic equipment. Suffice it to say that Dr. Buteyko was not your average family doctor who stumbled on a simple health concept. In fact, he claimed to have made a discovery so vast that it would one day turn the whole of modern medicine on its head. And his obsession with it led him from being an elite and privileged scientist in the Soviet system to becoming a medical dissident. What was it that he discovered? Having an intense interest in sophisticated diagnostics, Dr. Buteyko began an exhaustive investigation into the physiological and biochemical delineations between healthy and chronically ill people. The Institute of Clinical Experimental Medicine enabled him to use and develop facilities and equipment on a scale and sophistication that is usually reserved for high-priority military research. Before going any further, we should clarify something. There are different categories of disease. There are contagious or infectious diseases, such as hepatitis, and there are diseases which are congenital, such as birth defects. And there are chronic diseases. Chronic diseases used to be called the diseases of civilization, because they occurred with greater frequency in urbanized or more civilized communities and have grown with the so-called modernizing of human society. Chronic diseases are conditions such as asthma, allergies, bronchitis, cancer, chronic fatigue, depression, diabetes type 2, emphysema, high blood pressure, hormonal problems, migraine, and systemic problems such as MS and lupus. In fact, some 200 conditions fit into the category of chronic disease. There are some 30,000 diseases known to modern medicine. But chronic diseases only number around 200. But by far, they are the most prevalent and cause the most suffering for contemporary human beings. Dr.Buteyko's research and subsequent method mainly applies to chronic disease. Coming back to Dr.Buteyko's discovery, what was it that he discovered? It was that one particular parameter indicated chronic disease more than any other. And that parameter was the level of carbon dioxide within the human organism. Carbon dioxide? But isn't carbon dioxide a deadly pollutant? No, that's carbon monoxide, a different substance entirely. But there are claims that carbon dioxide is a pollutant because it occurs in industry. When in fact most of it occurs naturally and is a vital part of all organic life. Dr.Buteyko's research showed that when a subject had an optimal level of carbon dioxide, they never suffered with any chronic disease whatsoever. But all subjects that sustained any one of the several hundred chronic disease permutations all shared one attribute: a lower than optimal level of carbon dioxide. Furthermore, the greater the deficiency of carbon dioxide, the worse or more severe their disease and or subsequent level of health. In other words, Dr.Buteyko discovered a linear relationship between chronic disease and the level of carbon dioxide within the human organism. This discovery stunned him and gave him the direction for his future research. According to established medical textbooks, the physiological norm or optimal level of carbon dioxide in the human organism is around 7%. A very sharp contrast to the level in our atmosphere of around 0.035%. Roughly speaking, the human organism requires around a 200 times greater concentration of carbon dioxide than what is in the air that we breathe.